Hello students, today we are going to start our chapter number 7, coordinate geometry, class 10th. As we have studied in the 9th class also coordinate geometry, so let us recall it. So observe this grid. Here the columns in this grid are lettered from A, B, C, D and so on. Similarly, for rows, it is numbered from 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 6. Now, let's take a point here is denoted by x, or in this box, the variable x is written. So, this x, if we want to write what is the position of this point x or this variable x, we say it is in the column number D and row number 3. So the position of this point or position of this x is D3. Now here D and 3 both are called the coordinates of this particular box. Now here it is two parts. First is column and second is row. Now in this grid there are many boxes where each box has the unique value for its position. A system of geometry where the position of points on the plane is described using an ordered pair of numbers. The system is known as coordinate geometry. So, what is the meaning of coordinate plane? So, here this plane is known as the coordinate plane as it shows the coordinate axis. So, it is known as the coordinate plane. In coordinate geometry, points are placed on the coordinate plane. This is, it has two scales, that is the two axes x and y, or we can say x dash ox and y o y dash. These two axes are known as the coordinate axes, and which divides the plane into four parts. Here the axis x and y intersect at a point. This point is known as the origin, and the value for x and y both are 0 at the point O, as this is the origin. Now again, if this is the coordinate plane, so whatever the values, the right position from origin to x-axis, right direction, the all values are the positive values, and this point O, origin, from this point left direction, all the values are negative. Similarly, the values above this origin, this point, all are the positive, and the values which are below this origin are the negative for y-axis. Now vertical, this axis is known as the y-axis, and horizontal x, that is the x-axis. So right hand side of the horizontal line is positive values, and left hand side for x-axis is the left direction. Similarly, from the above origin, all the points are positive y-axis, and the points below the origin for y-axis all are the negative points or negative values or negative axis. Now take a point is here. Now if we want to write the position of this point, so we can write it is name of this point, and when we draw the perpendicular from this point O to the x-axis, we get the point value is perpendicular is on 20. Similarly, when we draw the perpendicular from this point O, we get on the point 15 on the y and positive direction. And here also the x is the positive direction. So both x and y are values, we get the positive. So we can write the name of the point is A and its coordinates are 20, 15. This is the ordered pair. This way of writing is, it is known as the ordered pair. Now here this 20 is the first value for this ordered pair. So we have to remember that whenever the value is given first, it is for the x-axis, and what the second value is for the y-axis. So for writing, we have to always remember the first shows the value of x-axis and second number or second value is for the y-axis. In this figure, the point A has an x value of 20 and y value is of 15. So there are coordinates of the point A. These the 20, 15 are the coordinates. So this referred to as its rectangular coordinates, or we can say coordinate plane, and 20, 15 are the coordinates of point A. Now this 20, the value for x-axis, it is also known as abscissa. And the value 15 for the y-axis is the ordinate. Now, when the two axes intersect at a point in a plane, then the plane divides in four parts. All these four parts are known as the quadrant. So, this is the first quadrant where both x and y values are positive. This is the second quadrant. So, here the value of x is negative, y is positive. Third quadrant where both the values are negative, and in the fourth quadrant x is for x, that is positive value, and y is the negative value. So we have to remember this first quadrant, that is plus plus, that is x and y both are plus. In the second quadrant x is minus and y is plus. In the third quadrant both x and y are minus, and in the fourth quadrant x is plus and y is minus. So these are the quadrant. Now let us remember, this is a famous mathematician. So he gave the method of describing the point in this way. So it is the method of describing the location of points in this way was proposed by this French mathematician René Descartes, pronounced as Cart. He proposed further that curves and lines could be described by equation using the this technique, thus being the first to link algebra and geometry. He is the first to link the algebra and the geometry. In honor of his work, the coordinates of a point are often referred to as its Cartesian coordinates, and the coordinate plane as the Cartesian coordinate plane. Now the things which can do in the coordinate geometry. So what we have to do in the coordinate geometry? So first of all, if we know the coordinates of a group of points, then we can determine the distance between them. We can find the midpoint and the equation of the line segment. We can find the ratio in which x or y axis divides the line segment joining the two points. We can also find out the lines are parallel or perpendicular, and also find the area and perimeter of a polygon defined by the points in the coordinate plane. So these points we can do in the coordinate geometry.